Israel Solorio was a 22-year-old young man. He was unloading a commercial truck at a Didi diaper company in Pasadena when all of a sudden, without any warning, the truck just blew up.
But the story starts many years before. At the end of the Cold War, many defense contractors no longer had military contracts, so they went into the private sector. And there was not the type of oversight that is required of product manufacturers. And such agencies as NASA, NHTSA, Department of Energy did not provide guidelines or safety testing that was required, and the CNG tanks were allowed to get out into the public domain and cause many serious injuries.
And so what we found is there's too much of a cozy relationship between federal regulators and the industry people that sit on all these safety committees, and conscious decisions were made to have a lower burst safety factor for use of these vessels in a motor vehicle setting as opposed to trains or planes.
As a result of this case, we were able to conduct extensive investigation and testing and provide that information to the federal government, specifically NASA, NHTSA, and the Department of Energy.
This case is changing that standard, number one, because we made a difference. We hit hard one of the primary players in this industry by the results of this case. But more importantly, we put a lot of evidence into the public domain that will help in future research.
Many, many explosions have occurred in the United States, causing deaths and serious injuries. This case is putting a stop to that.
Today, as a result of the settlement we obtained for Israel, he was able to purchase a beautiful home in Pasadena where he lives with his parents, his sister, and young children. Israel has a very bright future ahead of him now.